Hello, this is Jeff Woodman. I'm a systems engineer with Viavi Solutions, and this is another short video on the ongoing series relating directly to the UltraFed 2B or the ultra far end device. Basically, what this is like is having a friend of yours or a fellow tech out in the field working with you on the opposite end of the loop. And I hear from many techs all the time that they always say that if they can get to both ends of the loop that they're working on, give them a little bit of time and they can identify and locate just about any fault that's out there. So that's the whole purpose and intent behind this very small little box here. As made mention earlier in some of the other videos relating to the UltraFed, some of the actual test functions are embedded in some of the tests themselves, and then there is the menu in there that you can see the UltraFed control under the copper test. So today this is going to be again a short video, basic instruction on what we call the TDR helper. And that's nothing more than placing the UltraFed on the far end of your loop out there, going back to your point of access with your ONX, and using it to identify that you really do have that fault bracketed. What it's going to do when it's enabled is it's going to put a short and then an open back and forth on your pair. Just like, again, having a buddy out there or somebody in the central office taking their snips out, and you give them the cable pair and they short the lugs and the switch, or out in the far end, they do the same thing. And just so you can identify that you've got your fault out there that's bracketed, you've gone far enough. And you can actually see the open and the short as they happen. So, very simply, we're going to go into TDR here, make that selection. Let the test open up and initialize here. It'll come up on our display. And one of the other things I need to keep reminding you about is I've gone out, and I'm doing this on a loop fault simulator, but I've attached it just on pair one, the tip and ring leads. Pair one is identified with the overbinder. It's a blue overbinder. And then I've got a separate pair, and then the central office pair, the separate pair. Or pair two is with a red overbinder and the CO is with a yellow overbinder. So we've got some real capability with this unit to do more than just a single pair. But for the length of this video, we're just going to talk about just again getting back to the TDR helper. I've connected or made the connection out at the far end of the loop. I've come back to my access point with my ONX. And I've set up a couple of little parameters here with gain, just to get it to where I think I can see, get a good visual on, an open or a short. And I've got a range set up here so that I think I'm out there far enough to where I'm going to be able to see it. And it's sitting out there, even though it's connected, it's in an open state. So I can kind of see that. That big old open up there, and I've got a short in there between us and where the UltraFed is actually connected. And you could see that to the left there. So I've got my TDR actually running. What I'm going to do is go down to the second soft key, which is options. And I'm going to select UltraFed TDR option. And then you'll notice that it'll come up, and you've got a duration here that you can actually set the length of how long you want this to sit there and short the pair and then open the pair. I don't want it to stay on there for, as long as a minute and 10 seconds. So I'm going to back this thing way down for the demo today. I'm going to run it for about 25 seconds. I've just got pair one connected. As you see up there, I could connect the second pair if I wanted to, if I was doing some comparisons. And I'm simply going to hit the word send in the little box there. So once I've done that, it's going to send some tones out. Again, it's initialized with DTMF tones, and what it's doing right now is waking the far-end device up. So we've got to initialize that. We're out there, and the counter up in the top right is starting to count down the time. You see a short go on there, and then it goes open, and I can run my cursor from left to right out there, and I can see that my short and open is happening at about 1935 feet. So I know that this particular short that's out there that I've got on there is definitely well bracketed. And once the timer has timed out, again, it goes off and turns the UltraFed into its off and through state. And there you go. Pretty simple procedure, but very helpful if you're out there and you want to know for sure that you've got your fault bracketed and you can see out to where you've actually connected the far end device. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks very much for your attention. There'll be more coming. Thanks very much.